Welcome all friends in the Dhamma for this session. You know how to apply mindfulness and awareness collectively in your life. That means you practice in your family, your work. You have job, you have family, you do best for your family, do best in your work. That is you practice mindfulness and awareness, okay? Normally people, when doing work, thinking, coming to practice meditation in the temple, during the Monday to Friday, they rush to work so that this weekend I will go to see master and practice meditation. So you do in your daily life in a rush. Just finish, but not perfectly. Okay? When you come to temple, wow, thinking a lot about your job, not well done, huh? When you stay in temple, you're thinking of your office, your house. When you stay at your house, you're thinking of a temple. Something like that, not good. You're working, you're thinking to do best. You do best, that means you do what your commitment with your job, okay? Commitment coming with duties and responsibility. That is the way you apply mindfulness and awareness collectively in your life, okay? So you sometimes, people, even someone in the history, he fighting in a troop, but he can sleep on a gun, okay? He can sleep on a gun. Winston Churchill, maybe? I don't know. Or who? Yeah, he can shut his mind, okay? On a gun, fighting, but he shut his mind, sleeping on a gun.
Sleeping,
just sleeping. Yeah, so that's why that means you're not sleeping in your work, but just quiet, okay? Practice being quiet all time. In your work, many problems, quiet first. Collective, calming, mindfulness and awareness. And then you know, you got your answer from inside how to do, okay? You have your children very stubborn. You speak a lot, they never listen to you. Now you quiet first. And seeing what they are doing, and seeing what they are doing with quietness, you have something in your mind, accept what they do and understand what they do, okay? When you quiet, you accept, but you not quiet, you not accept what they do, good, not good, wrong, unwrong, all everything wrong. But when you quiet, even when they do bad, okay, forgiveness, accept, okay? And then you just have wisdom to teach your children with wisdom. First you know this process to develop wisdom. Wisdom, that means you apply with mindfulness and awareness, with quietness. In the quietness, you hear things, you listen to things, and accept what they are, okay? Not force, just accept things as they really are. When you accept, sometimes problem gone. Sometimes you just accept, do nothing. Now problem gone, no problem. The problem because you not accept, okay? You not accept that your children Why stubborn? When you quiet, oh, before I'm a kid, I'm stubborn also. So then you accept, okay? When you accept, you got wisdom, okay? So also this session, okay? When we have mindfulness and awareness, quiet and smiling, you accept what feeling, what story in your mind happening, okay? Before you not accept, you have doubt, or you want to fight, want to stop thinking. Now accept, just be mindful, quiet, learn things with accept and understanding. This is the same thing. The way to develop wisdom, mindfulness, and then accept understanding. So now you mindful, quiet, you know, okay, still a lot of story in your thought. Accept first, don't close your eye, just accept, okay. Thinking first until it's finished. You're thinking and you get solution and finish, okay. Or if not solution, not get solution, but you accept it, then it weaker, it's fading away. Accept it first, okay, while thinking. Oh, still worry, okay, worry. Why worry? Still need something. Accept you have wisdom in your mind. Why need something? Because attachment, okay? Or sameness. Why sameness? Oh, you see, why sameness? Because a lot of hope. Hope to be that, hope to be this. A lot of desire. Why desire? Oh, because I am a manager, I am a head, a chief. This nama rupa. Now not general, but very big man. Very big boss. So need to have attachment. So you get suffering, okay? Why a big boss? You are born to die? Oh, I'm born and die. Every die? Everybody the same. Why you make you bigger than them? Why you make yourself higher than them?
To reach.
They all go to OS. You go to OS, they go to die, you go to die. Oh, we are Dhamma friends. Oh, we are Dhamma friends. Oh, that's all. Stupid gone, huh? And enlightened come, huh? So that's why when you just be mindful with quietness, a lot of story that with attachment, with desire, with hope coming, you just ask why. Mindfulness, when you apply wisdom to your mind with mindfulness, you just use very short word, why, or short sentence. Or short sentence. Why still burden? You not tired? Short sentence. With mindfulness, you just talk to your mind, short sentence or short word, not many sentences, because many sentences is come from your thought. Okay? Just short one. Why? Not enough? Oh, not enough. Oh. What happened? Oh, they are happy. Now I am suffering because I'm not enough. Okay, they gone already, they happy, but I'm still suffering, okay? Because I expect they give me more, but they gone already. Why? So now you quiet mindfulness will have wisdom to train your mind at that moment นะ we say critical mind นะ not thinking mind just critical mind short sentence short word at that time and finish okayOkay, so now you see we start with quietness. We become relaxed and alert and awakened. Okay, and before we get wisdom, we start with the power of mind. With quietness, become relaxed, and also stillness.In the quietness, that means quietness not shakeable, not movable. Okay, stillness how? Awaken quietness first. Stillness just know at the present time. Now you know you're sitting, or now you know you're sitting and breathing. Just know only know clearly, nah.Or you can say concentrate, but concentrate now. When you concentrate, you have quietness. When you concentrate, the mind focus, but your quietness it expanding. Okay. So we start from expand your mind first with relaxation. Okay. We not start from focus first. We start from expand your mind.That means we start from mindfulness first. Expand your mind with mindfulness, with quietness and awareness, smiling. First, when we start meditation to get wisdom, you expand your mind, okay? With relaxation, because when you expand your mind, you in your mind, there are both defilements and wisdom in your mind.When you expand your mind, you see, this thing no good, let go. This thing good, keep it, okay? Take it or apply it, okay? You expand your mind first, and then you can see good thing, better things, and neater and softer. The way to go to deep meditation, that means realize thing that neater and neater,softer and softer in your mind. Even you have a good mind now, but expand your mind, okay? With awareness and mindfulness, you see some better, neater. Before you think now is good now, but still is something neater, softer, until when you go to the end, you get freedom. That is the best.Now is good, is joy and pleasure, but still not freedom. Okay, so you look something by mindfulness looking. If you look by thought, by selfness, by intention, you cannot find freedom. Okay. So now just be quiet and observe with mindfulness, the great one, the natural one.In a crowd, in a cloudy event, in the embarrassment, in the trouble, there is some good thing in that. Okay. So even you thinking a lot, feeling a lot of sorry, but you have good.Thing in your mind, you have purified mind. Everybody has the same purified mind, but can you find it? Yes, you need to be quiet first. Quiet, then you see. Oh, first I thought that I should kill myself. So sad, so bad, so unhappy. But when you quiet, I got some good thing in my life, in my mind.Is something different from eager or desire, but is something like free from ego and desire. That means peacefulness. Okay. Peacefulness and happiness. Rely on yourself. So that means we practice meditation. What we practice? We practice to stay alone without trouble. To stay alone with freedom. You think your children will take care you until you die? No, sometimes not. Get you in the homestay, That's why you need to practice staying alone with freedom. When you get freedom, you shouldn't come to see you. When you get worried, they not come. They run away. But then when you freedom, they think, why? My dad, mom changing, not as before. Before, requiring a lot of things. Now, why? Quiet. I just go to see my mom. Okay. Same, you go to see lover. You require a lot. You require a lot. You quiet. He come to see you.
After too many problems.
So you know this is the powerful mind, nah? The quality of mind. You clean up your mind first. Everybody come, good one come to see you. If you not clean up your mind, you do business, you have a lot of struggle, have a lot of, should get money now, but somebody take it. Because your mind not purified. But your mind, okay, purify, I should get it, because I do it. But okay, I am doing a job. Not worry. But if you worry, maybe you lose, okay? Now you know, quiet and stay with yourself alone with peacefulness. How to be peaceful? Quiet, already peacefulness. And how to stay with yourself? Peacefulness. Breathing, naturally calm. You see, when you quiet, you go away from your close friend. This is your close friend, bleeding. Really close friend. Because if he apart from you, you die. Okay? Now you come to know, to stay with your close friend. Okay? So that's why now you will learn about how to develop peacefulness with anapanasati, with the breathing. There are two ways. The first way to practice, that means focus, concentration. But the second way, Lord Buddha say, if Brahman asks where or how Lord Buddha staying this vasa, you should tell all Brahman that Lord Buddha stay with anapanasati as a refuge. Staying as a refuge, different from practice anapanasati. I'm staying on the chair, I'm sitting on the chair. I have to try to sit on the chair. I have to? No, I sit already. Sit, it means sitting. You don't have to concentrate on sitting, concentrate. No need, okay? So, you practice is the way, but when you have a left field, anapanasati as a left field, you have fruition, okay? So fruition is already there when you start practice. When you start practice, breathing, you breathing now. fruition of quietness happening? Happening already from the beginning. But you not sure, you are afraid. Is correct? Not. How? And what result? What the outcome? You have so many questions. So if you just quiet, oh, the fruition already there. So now, sometimes you practice anapanasati with concentration. But sometimes you should just stay with anapanasati as a refuge or fruition. Okay? Because Lord Buddha said, you can stay with anapanasati all day. Lord Buddha said about one town, one city. These people in the town, they talk about how about your breathing? How about your feeling with breathing? Breathing good, breathing well? You know you're breathing all day? Oh, this city, the people in this city, they stay with anapanasati as a refuge. But most of us never stay with with anapanasati as a refuge. Now you just see that very easy. You're breathing already. You're not, sometimes you concentrate. Sometimes you take a rest. Just fruition. Just stay with the fruition. When you stay with the fruition, just breathing naturally and quietly. Now you can stay with anapanasati all day. You see, sometimes you are in a hurry. What you will see first? When you start to be in a hurry, the refuge, your refuge, the breathing changing, not your refuge, is strong and hard, okay? Then when you see that, you just leave the refuge, leave it strong and hard, you just keep calm, quiet, come back, and breathing one time, two times. My refuge come back already. Then I can work smart, work quietly, okay? When you talk to people, talk, they make you upset. Now you see the breathing change. Before angry, your breathing change first. Then when you know, where my refuge? So rough. Stop, you stop. You just take a seat somewhere first. I drink coffee. Just cool down. Okay. Okay. Cool down 1-2 minutes. My refuge come back. Okay. Come on, boy. What you need? Okay. We talk later. Okay. So also, when you talk to your children. Again, you left you gone. Make mom upset. Mom, money. Oh, upset. Now, okay. If you cannot cool down, you go to take a shower. Now my left you come back. Okay. So, when you practice anapanasati in the frame of practice, you need sitting and closing your eyes. But if you practice as a refuge, you don't have to have any frame of practice. You just observe. Your breathing still good? Your friend still with you? Or running? Okay? If your friend running, just quiet and take your friend back. Because if your friend running, your money running. Sure. Because you will clumsy, will embarrass, and maybe forget. 1,000, 1,000,000. Sign up. Forget everything. Your friend, come back first. Come back. My friend, come back. So now, whenever in your daily life, you feel, your breathing no good, just cool down first. Cool down 1 minute, or maybe 10 seconds. or 5 seconds and then talking or working. Okay? This is why all meditator not go progressively in the practice, because they a lot of attempt in the practice, but after practice throw away, living at the temple. Okay. So now you need to bring them with you as level. As level, you see, if you practice, how you working and you concentrate the breathing, how cannot, huh? You talking, you concentrate the breathing, can you? Cannot. But you talking, just awareness, breathing good, can you? Can. Okay? Just awareness of the breathing still okay? Good. If good, we continue talking. If not good, you keep sitting. Go away first. Okay? So this is important because Lord Buddha mentioned about anapanasati two ways. One way in the practice, the second way as a refuge. Okay? As a refuge, we just know by heart, by awareness. When we know or aware of the breathing good, we can do the job well because it's cool down. Okay? We can talk well, talk politely, and we can when we talk, people respect what we talk, believe in what we talk, okay? Because we talk with calm down, okay? Calm down, we not rush, okay? So now, if you would like also your good health, always, if something disturb you, my friend, now gone again, just stop and cool down 1 minute, okay? 10 seconds, okay? So now, this session, just quiet, and you see in the quietness, you already know the breathing without focus, okay? That is the way we develop the peacefulness, by develop anapanasati as a refuge, not as a practice, okay? Okay? Now just sitting for a while, so you learn yourself and prove yourself is true or not. Just quiet. You know, breathing long or short or smooth or fast or slowly, you know? Can you know? And when you know breathing, you can do a job. Now you know breathing, you do a job with me. Listen Dhamma to me. That's right. You know breathing, you can listen to Dhamma. Yes. At quietness. You know breathing with quietness, you can hear something, you can look at something, and you see the quality of hearing and looking really good, really keen, because your mind calm down, cool down all the time. You might hear awareness of the breathing softly. What you doing, good quality. You driving, you just know breathing, little, okay? Then when you see the way, very carefully, okay? Because mind stay with yourself. Before you don't know the breathing, not awareness of the breathing, the mind gone. Driving, wow, when, why traffic? I make appointment. Oh, your mind gone. Okay? So you just keep your mind stay and sit on the reading like I'm sit on the chair. I don't need to try to sit. I sit is sitting. Just stay on anapanasati as a level. So now you will have no doubt why master not tell you to concentrate. Because there are two ways of practice. Concentration for the formal practice, okay? And this formal practice emphasizing samatha, make the power of mind. in the 16 state of Anapana state. The first four one, we know the breathing and we see the breathing. But after number 5 to number 16, we know the breathing, but we see feeling. And then we see mind. And then we see quality of mind, the Dhamma. So you see, now you know you're breathing. You see Dhamma. Everything you see is the Dhamma. All Dhamma. Because everything is just impermanent nature. You see, just impermanent nature. Okay? You know breathing and know the, see the Dhamma changing, changing, no trouble. I know, you change all the time. Okay. Now you know and you see. So when you close your eye, knowing, no need to look at the breathing, but see Dhamma. See Dhamma where? In your mind. That means seeing your feeling, okay? And also, Dhamma in your mind sometimes becoming image. We call Dhamma outside. Dhamma in your mind, we call Dhamma inside. That means Dhamma inside and Dhamma outside. Inside means feeling or thought. Outside means image, any image. Okay? So now you know that when you see Dhamma both inside and outside, you're not sleepy. Because your inner eye working both inside and outside. It's awakened all the time. Your consciousness forming a stable energy in front, not go down. Okay? So before we close our eye, just practice seeing inside first. Practicing inside first, you open your eye. You look at me. Quiet. You see how you feeling? You not look only at me. You change. You are looking. Looking at somebody else. You see your feeling change. You looking somebody. You looking at the trees. Your mindfulness went quiet. You see your feeling change. Okay? Same. When you close your eye, maybe image changing a lot. Light, dark, colorful. You see what happens in your feeling. Okay? Until you are feeling purified. Image. Emptiness. Okay? Understand now? So, now I explain one more thing. Practice breathing one more. Open your eye. When I tell you breathing, start beginning here, middle, that means it's come inwards in the brain. And the end, that means the breathing come through your chest inside. And I tell you, smiling, happily, and empty or let go. Maybe you don't understand. Make this way. Make this way. Smiling happily and relax. You understand? When you relax, you let go on cranky. Okay? So when you're breathing out, do nothing. Just relax. Okay? Breathing in, we just practice good breathing first before we go in the meditation. Breathing in, smiling, and you feel in the middle happily, really light in your brain, okay? And really light and really fresh in your chest. Relax, relax, okay? Breathing out.
When you relax,
Sanjay. Huh?
When you relax at time. Breathing in smiling happily, then come down here, and then it relax.
When it come down here, and it's going to breathing out,
that's right.
We relax from is stop and going to breathing out, and while breathing out, still more relaxed, peacefully relaxed, peacefully relaxed. Okay.
But the awareness is still going out. Yeah.
Or going out, but we not pay attention.
Not pay attention.
Because you know the technique of Anapanasati. Your breathing in will bring your feeling and mind go stay inwards. So the technique is when you follow your breathing in inwards and it stops somewhere, I don't know, stops somewhere and it become relaxed. That is the gate, the way. You just realize there. First you realize relax, okay? After you realize letting go. After realize emptiness. There is turning point. Turning point. First maybe 1 second. Later you can realize 2 seconds. And that is between is the gap that you can go deep meditation.
I see. So can we focus on that?
Not focus. We just realize really quick. And just stay there. First you can stay there 1 second. After you can stay there 1, 2 seconds, 3 seconds. But after it's over the time, it's beyond the time. It's beyond the time. When you go there and it's go in the mind, it's no time. Maybe you stay a long time, oh, 1 hour, you go in inside. Okay? That's the way to go deep meditation. But before going to deep meditation, we practice mindfulness first, because if you go deep meditation without mindfulness, that means you not awaken. You go deep and you sleeping, okay? You sleeping, okay? But if you go deep with mindfulness, like Ajahn Piya yesterday told me, he go deep and then he not feel about the body because the inner body come out sitting in front of her, okay? Yeah, and that's why when he use the power, is the power from the inner body come out and healing and just help you to have a good health, okay? To cure your sickness, to cure your sickness, okay? Because it's from the inner body that has a power. This body no power, only no power, but inner power, inner very power. Touching, oh, you feel full. Huh? This no power, only loud noise, no power. Okay, but when we use power, we use from inside. Okay, and that's why sometimes we use the inner body. Just you are sick, the inner body, when you get used to go in that turning point and then you have mindfulness, then it's come out, okay? It's separate from the body, but don't pay too much attention. If you try, you're not successful, okay? But just maybe, just realize only, not hope. Not try, okay? Just realize. And when you have balance, meditation, mindfulness, and wisdom, it free from the body. And the inner body comes sitting in front of you and see you are sitting. Okay? And this inner body can help curing all the sickness out from you, okay? Also. So this is why she has this, because she practiced more than 30 years. She got this one 30 years before, and then she developed this way, okay? Okay, now you know that why I tell you beginning, middle, and the end, relax. Because we would like to use the relax as a key to open the door, okay? But difficult, cannot explain how to open. Open the door, relax. just relax and letting go. No, no hope, no doubt. Relax, relax. And then you come in the subconscious, and you come in the subconscious with mindfulness. Then the inner body come out, okay, and sit in front of you. Later, next time I show the picture, because my master writing detail of this image, okay, this image about the inner body coming out, and you can feel the inner body can feel that this body has the heart vibration. The inner body no heart, just purify and see this body sitting, and the inner body just see that this body not yours, is go to sickness, is go to die, okay? But the inner body that will rebirth and rebirth, okay? Okay.
Can we call the inner body jitta?
Inner body, Atisman Gai. We call Atisman Gai.
Jitta.
Jitta. No, not jitta. Jitta. The inner body, the center is the jitta. Okay? But the jitta, because this jitta still have defilement. So this citta forming a new body, okay? If citta only, that means no defilement already. Nippon, Arahant, purify already. As far as we have the inner body, we still rebirth. When we purify the mind until the inner body, no nothing, nothing. Only the citta only, that we Arahant. Nippon, okay? But everybody still have inner body because you have lust, anger, ignorance. So inner body will come out. Sometimes it's walking around to see, to look at this body, because first experience. Why? I stay with this body. How this body? So next time I bring the book, show you the picture. Okay?
Uh-huh. At this level where one experiences the inner body coming out, I'm just wondering, where is the place of jhanas? I mean, do you have to learn about, are jhanas involved here?
Jhana or chana? Jhana or jhana?
Jhana.
To get to that stage where one is experiencing the inner body, right, as you said, coming out. Are you already at whatever jhana level?
Oh, it's just starting. Just starting. It need to develop more. It's just starting. We call the knower. The knower form the new body. But this knower with new body need to develop. Develop this way. The new body, seeing this body, impermanent, okay? Impermanent. Until this new inner body more purified, okay? And then you need practice, go out and come in, go out, okay? But is this, we develop jhana, okay? But when we develop jhana, we don't need to have inner body come out. But if we have deep, I tell about deep concentration. If deep concentration, then inner body separate from the fleshy body come out and develop jhana. Jhana is the advanced meditation. And then from advanced meditation, develop jhana. Okay? Jhana with jhana, very powerful. Okay? But now, I don't expect everybody, inner body come out. No, just stay there, okay? Because I just let you to develop jhana Jhana is the wisdom because develop jhana. It depends on what you practice in the previous life. If you never become a yogi on the Himalaya, maybe you cannot come out. Okay. Okay. So maybe she as a yogi before. So inner body come out, and this inner body can traveling to the U.S., to the Europe, to anywhere, to outside the world. Okay. No pay air ticket.
Is this what you call astral traveling.
Astral traveling.
And this is energy.
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 With citta.
With citta. Energy.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. But anyhow, today we just okay keep inside, huh? No need, huh? No need. Okay, because how many years you practice? Just start. She practice 30 years.
We watch television 30 years. We watch astro 30 years.
Okay. So that's why she got the power to heal people, okay? Got the power. Even somebody illness in the U.S. and make a phone call, just the inner body going hell to kill, okay? You understand? Very fast, okay? Okay, now just be quiet and stay with Anapanasati as a level. Just know how peacefully you breathing. Okay? When you know how peacefully you breathing, you see there is a turning point before the breathing out. It stop 1 second or 2 seconds. Realize that if you want to develop deep meditation. But anyhow, don't worry. Not too deep now. Just more awakened first, okay? More awakened first. Just relax there, okay? It's the key. Relax, relax. And you understand by yourself, relax and let go. And everything is what different, okay? Just relax, okay? Just maybe you can practice in your life. Sharing things, talk to people. But smiling, happily breathing, and relax, relaxing, and let go, relaxing when breathing out, okay? And breathing in, knowing the breathing in, smiling, happily, and relaxing. And breathing out, don't worry, let go, okay? So this you can do in your daily life, okay? And you will see that your breathing will become longer and deeper, okay? Okay, just practice breathing first. Smiling, happily breathing, and happily in the middle, happily in the end, and relaxing, okay? Relaxing. And let go. Don't follow the breathing out. Let go. Don't worry. And when breathing in again, just smiling, happily breathing from the beginning to the middle to the end. So it will be easy if you smiling first, smiling and breathing, smilingly, happily, relaxing, let go, breathing out. Don't worry, don't follow, let go. And breathing in. And just happily and relaxing. So now you stay as Anapanasati, as a left view. You don't have to concentrate. You just know the whole breathing, okay? So nice, that's all, okay? Now, even you open your eye, your whole breathing so nice. If you smiling and quiet, you know inwards what happening inside. Okay, quiet, bringing your mindfulness inwards. Smiling, bringing your awareness inwards. Then you can know the whole breathing so nice. Okay. Somebody you know they breathing and you know they breathing so hard. Oh, but you breathing so profoundly, softly, because you are very quiet and you have awareness deep in your smiling. I go to check with the heart vibration. My heart vibration steady. Somebody pop pop. Steady. And my aura so big. My aura, they check scanning my aura, and then they say, this is a super healer. Really powerful.
So you go to your bonus screen.
I just have a machine to see the aura.
Yeah, in Thailand we have. Yeah. You don't have here?
Very few places.
Oh, there is one wonderful computer program. You see on the computer, and it's changing. You just smiling, it's changing. You just breathing softly, it's changing. All are changing. You not smiling, it's narrow. You just frightened, it's gone. And then you can have a video, camera, and video camera. And record the computer, and you just put your hand and breathing, and just to see how mindful is and how the aura is. It's changing. This is for education. There is one in Thailand. I just they asked me to try, and I try.
In Bangkok.
You want to try? Yeah, you can. This machine 1 million baht, huh? 1 million baht. No, they buy.
1 million baht is bankrupt. Go, bye-bye.
Yeah, all right. Very good. And okay, now we come to left field again. Now just breathing softly. Open your eye first. Before, if you start, close your eye with loud breathing. You work too hard, okay? When before you close your eye, you breathing until it's smart and really beautiful, softly. When you close your eye, 1 second, calmness there, okay? You still hard, not close your eye. Just quiet, smiling. It's more beautiful breathing, quiet, and awareness. That's right? And not try. Strain your eye, no. Just beautiful eye. Just look around. Look the nature. Look at the nature. Okay. Just work inside and look at the nature. You see, you can realize beautiful breathing softly inside. Cannot try. Cannot focus because this is the third state of anapanasati. If you focus, you come. To focus here is the first and the second state of anapanasati. The third state cannot focus. cannot concentrate. Just clearly know how the breathing is. Okay? Just clearly know so nice, so softly the breathing is inside. And outside, you know. If breathing in, you know, but you not pay concentration there. You just clearly know inside and then cross your eyes. With smiling and quiet. Quiet and smiling. And relax. And relax. Just quiet. And you can see how you feel, how your feeling is. And still there is thought. You can see thought also, okay? So you can see thought and feeling still there, but no trouble. So then be quiet, just quiet only. Now, quiet, you feel your head really light. It look like quiet until you, the top of head open. The head expanding. Okay, feeling, not true, it's not expanding, it's just feeling, okay? And your heart feel expanding, your mind expanding. Then, even you open your eyes, you feel right. You have a core inside, connect together. And you just smiling and quiet. And then close your eye. And I ask for the power of Buddha, Dhamma, and Sangha coming to your mind through the crown head. And going to the heart of smiling, staying there. Just smiling, happily, breathing, and relaxing. Smilingly, happily, and relaxing. Breathing out, let go. Smiling more and more with quietness. Now you feel the breathing so nice. It become pranic energy in your body, spreading throughout on all tissues of organ of your body. Just there, quiet and smiling. You know it become softer, neater, and relaxing. Smiling. Happily and relaxing. Smiling happily and relaxing. Still there is thought there. You just accept. Don't fight with thought. Just quiet, smiling with acceptance. Whatever still there, just accept. And understanding it. When you got understanding, you let go all attachment. When you let go all attachment, thought will be fading away. Smilingly, happily, and relaxing. Smilingly, happily, and relaxing. You know, very good, nice breathing, but you see your mind, that means your feeling becoming better, becoming soft, becoming neater. Smilingly, happily, and relaxing deeper. Smilingly, happily and relaxing is longer, maybe 1, 2, 2 or 3 seconds, and breathing out. just stay at the relaxing with quietness, smilingly, happily, and relaxing with quietness. It's longer, maybe 3 seconds, and breathing out. Don't force, not breathing out, just go natural. Smilingly, happily, and relaxing, and you see, letting go there. Relaxing with letting go. Breathing out, also letting go. Relaxing, smilingly, happily, relax. And more relaxing there, more emptiness there. And emptiness there, more and more is expanding. Emptiness is expanding around. Smilingly, happily, relaxing, and emptiness. More and more emptiness. Just accept what you feel so that you have no doubt. Accept and understand what you feel. Good or bad, you just accept it. Sometimes you do good now, sometimes you not do good now. Don't worry, just accept whatever be is be. Accept and understanding. Happily, smilingly, and understanding with emptiness. Emptiness with understanding. Deeper in your mind. Now, I will give Dhamma from Lord Buddha to you. And you understanding there. First, Lord Buddha said, all beings, when going to old age, will feel that life is not long. Smilingly, happily, and relaxing. You hear Dhamma from relaxing. You will realize the truth that now you're going to old age. And actually, you know now, life is not long as you thought before. Smilingly, happily, relaxing, and let go. Now you're feeling letting go because life is not long. Second, Lord Buddha said, all beings has no protection. You just smilingly, happily, relaxing, letting go there. And you understand what Lord Buddha said. Life has no protection because everybody has to go to illness, old age, and die. No protection, no medicine. Smilingly, happily, relaxing. You accept this truth, you understand this truth, then you got more freedom. Smilingly, happily, let's go. Letting go, smilingly, happily, letting go, because all going to illness and death. Smilingly, happily, and letting go. Relaxing and letting go, and you feel more emptiness there. And you listen to Dhamma from the emptiness there. All beings are born to die. Nobody can live long forever. You listen to this Dhamma from your emptiness mind, smilingly, happily, and letting go and emptiness. Your empty mind, realize the truth. And letting go more and more all defilement, all letting go, all attachment. Smilingly, happily, letting go. And you listen to the number four. Lord Buddha say, all being never enough. All being has a lot of desire and never enough. And are you enough? Smilingly, happily, and letting go. Are you enough? When you enough, you realize emptiness. Enough now, you my freedom. You realize freedom in the emptiness. Smilingly, happily, and emptiness with freedom of mind. Now you stay at the freedom of mind because you understand the truth. And you realize the truth from every mind. You realize the truth. Then you realize freedom. And you realize freedom in the empty mind. Smilingly, happily, and freedom. Your mind very stable and become peacefulness and freedom. Smilingly, happily, and freedom. In the freedom of mind, you know the whole thing, the whole feeling coming up and gone. New one coming up and gone. Nothing that you can be clinging to. You understand now, nothing can be cling, cannot be attached. Letting go is the way for freedom. Smilingly, happily, and freedom. You free the mind from all defilements. And not only free the mind, you see that the mind now free from all defilements, step by step, more and more. But still there, some defilements. But you just know and see by great mindfulness. When the mind freedom, the mind stable, not swaying, smilingly, happily, and freedom. Sometimes you see the mind swaying a little. You see when it's swaying a little, you can see it. But when you see it, it become stable and freedom. And you can see it stable and freedom, smilingly, happily, and freedom. Now, I ask for the power of Buddha, Dhamma, Sangha come to your mind, or everybody now. You feel more awakened? You feel more consciousness awakened? Feeling fresh and happy and smiling. Before we finish meditation, just review what we learned today. How calmness you feel, how quietness, how peacefulness you realize. How understanding you realize. How freedom you can free your mind. Now your mind move or not move, you realize. It doesn't move, you realize it doesn't move. It still move a little, you realize it still move a little. Now, you have the quality of mind to see inwards. Even the mind shakeable, you know the mind shakeable. The mind not shakeable, you know the mind not shakeable. The mind movable, you know the mind movable. The mind not movable, you see it. And the mind happy, happiness, you see the mind happiness. the mind joy and pleasure, you see the mind joy and pleasure. Because you stand at the point of freedom, you see all the performance of your mind. And you see all the performance of your mind as an impermanent nature that coming up and disappear. Coming up and gone. Nothing to be clinging to. Just impermanent nature. You realize the truth. Then, before we come out from meditation, we just feel awakened inside and giving love and kindness to everybody here, to everybody at home, office, to your mom, your dad, your son, your daughter, your niece, your nephew, and to your friends or even your enemies, to everybody in your country, and to everybody in the world, and all beings in the world, even the angels here, how much you have it. Let them feeling more and more happiness. Now, before you leave meditation, you can give love and kindness to especially the one who loves a lot. Just remind in your mind until you feel his or her face smiling in your mind. And then you're smiling at him or at her. Then just moving your body and quietness. And just come out from meditation, gradually opening your eyes. You still feel the stable of mind because you are quiet. Do nothing, just quiet. Quiet will make all collective. Mindfulness, awareness, or meditation, collective. Now we finish this session. Sadhu.
Sadhu. Sadhu.